I'm Brad Arrington with Mossy Pond Retrievers. What we'll be working on today is a double blind. This is Piper. She's a two-year-old master hunter. What we'll be working on today is her lines into the water. We have Piper very water committed, but we don't want her bailing into the water or bailing out of the water. We have our first blind we're going to start off with is an angle in a ditch, and we have about a 30-yard entry before she angles in. We want her to angle in this water on the line, her initial line that we give her from the line, and same as coming out of the ditch. We don't want her bailing out to cheat, and we don't want her to swim down the ditch to stay too water committed. We want her comfortable with getting out of the water. Then our second blind is going to have three entries and three exits of the water. We want her to be comfortable with entering the water on an angle, with not bailing into the water and trying to be good and trying to get in the water too soon. But we don't want her cheating the water and running down the bank. We want her to take the initial line that we give her and enter the water and exit the water the same way. Exit the water on the cast, don't bail out and try to cheat, and don't swim down the water and try to stay water committed. Take the cast and be comfortable with getting on the water. The way that Mossy Pond trains water and land, a verbal back means stay in the water and keep driving in the water and pushing. A silent means get on land, and then of course however we give the cast, but the silent means get on land, verbal means get back in the water. Here we go. Took a good initial line. She hit the water like I was wanting her to. She didn't fade with the factors. She didn't bail in too quick or fall off the hill, and or she didn't try to cheat the water. After she got in the ditch coming out on the other side, she did. I'm gonna call her in. After she was halfway through the ditch, she did want to square the bank and try to get out early. That's when I stopped her. I still had to give the silent because I wanted her to get out, and I gave the left hand back cast. If I would have gave that with a verbal, the way that we train here, if I would have gave that with a verbal, that would have mean stay in the water, and she might have swam all the way down the channel. So her initial line was very good. Getting out, she wanted to square a little. We didn't correct her, but we gave her the cast and she understood it, so we're teaching. On the next blind, if she does it again, I will give a correction. What I like to do is when I'm running multiple blinds, whether it be two or three or four, I like to have the same concept on that blind. So we're working on angles entries here. We're going to work on angle entries on the next blind. So you're teaching. You want to keep it black and white for the dogs. You don't want to work on entries here and then turn around and run a land blind that you're squaring cover or something. So maybe angle entries on water here. Tomorrow we might be doing angle entries on cover. So you want to stay with the same concept where you will be teaching the dog. This is where I'll give my verbal cast and get her back in the water. Did pretty good there. This is a very difficult blind. We got some corrections. She took a good initial line. She got in. She wanted to stay water committed. She was trying to go down that bank a little bit and stay in the water. I gave her a silent cast and put her back up on the land. She ran down. She wanted to cheat the water. We stopped her, gave her the verbal back that means to get in the water. She didn't take it. We gave her a black and white decision to make there. She didn't take it. We stopped her again, gave her a correction with the collar, brought her back into the spot where she messed up, give her the same cast with the verbal. She jumped in the water. So we're teaching that verbal more and more every day, even for an advanced dog. When she got up on the land, she got up on the angle, she got out in the angle, and then the corner up there, you have two angles coming in, and she struggled a little bit. We hacked her there at the end. I was trying to give the silent meaning to get back up on the land, and she was trying to stay a little water committed, so she got a little confused at the end. We're gonna actually rerun it one time and try to make it black and white for her, make her understand it. I don't like rerunning blinds a lot. I like I did on this first one, running this concept, angle entry in the water, angle out, exit onto the land, and the same here. But with this situation, she chopped it up pretty bad and got a correction. We are going to rerun it.